Okay, so let's export our layers from Illustrator to Photoshop. Basically, you need to release all clipping masks, then go to Export As, and then choose Photoshop PSD and make sure to write to layers. And that's it. So let's go through it. First, I need to release all clipping masks. So I'll select all with Command A or Control A. And then I'm going to come up here to Object, Clipping Mask, Release. You can also hit Option Command 7 or Alt Control 7 on a PC. So I've released it once and I need to just keep hitting that keyboard shortcut a few times until everything is released. Now, I don't know if you noticed, but it changed my color here, and that's because the clipping mask had a fill on it, and I'm just going to get rid of that fill so it matches the look. Now, when you bring this to Photoshop, you cannot have clipping masks or it won't work, so I wanted to make sure you know that. Another thing to know is this does not keep live vectors. It rasterizes everything except text. And if you have effects on your text, like a warp or something, it'll rasterize those too. So let's continue on. We'll go to File, Export, Export As, and then at the bottom here, I'll choose Photoshop PSD. And it's okay to have Use Artboards checked, but you don't have to. If you do, it'll cut the artwork off at the artboard bounds. So it'll cut off the artwork right here. I'm gonna go ahead and leave this checked and I'll export. I'm okay with the RGB color model. Resolution, I do want to be high at 300 PPI. And then make sure you choose Write Layers here. I wanna have both of these checked to preserve the text editability and just have maximum editability if we can. And then the other two, I'm gonna leave as is and say okay. Now I'll open the file we just created. And as you can see, it's cut off right where the artboard was. Now I'll look at my layers. And I'm just gonna select all and ungroup everything here so we can see what we've got. Now one thing it did, it put all these little pieces into separate layers. So it might be good to leave those in a group. You can kind of see all of them here. Then we have our text layers here, our icons here, and another text layer here. Now, as I mentioned before, all of these little pieces are raster. They are no longer vector images. So that is one kind of issue that I have with doing this. You lose all the vectors except for text. If this tip was quick and helpful for you, and you really like getting your answers right away at the beginning of the video, that's what I try to go for in my channel. So please subscribe if you like that style. If that tip didn't work for you, just keep watching. I'll go over some troubleshooting tips now. Now, usually when something isn't set right in Illustrator, it will just come up as one flattened layer in Photoshop. So the first thing to try, maybe you didn't release all clipping masks. Right now, it looks like my clipping mask is released. You can see it come all the way out to the edge here. But there's actually more clipping masks inside. So I'm just going to hit Option Command 7 a few times, or Alt Control 7 a few times on PC. The second problem you might be having is make sure you don't have anything in the artwork set to overprint. So to fix this, or to make sure it's not happening, select all with Command A or Control A. Go to Window, Attributes. You'll see Overprint Fill and Overprint Stroke. Click on the first one and say Proceed, and then uncheck it. And do the same with the second one. So nothing is checked like this. And then export again, and then see if you have layers in your Photoshop file. The third thing to try is to remove all transparency in all objects, because having any transparency can cause the file to come in as one flattened layer in Photoshop. All right, I think that covers everything, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.